Shalom, Chavarim. I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live here on live stream this evening, or this morning, actually. I know it's early in the United States. There has been multiple suicide bombers reported in Syria. This is close to Latakia, where Russia has its own naval base there. The attacks have left more than 100 people dead thus far, according to reports coming out of there. RT News is the one that first brought this out. And says their one jihadist group, Ahrar al-Sham al-Islamiyah, took responsibility for the blast in both Jabal and Tardis. But then the Islamic State militants also claimed the attack, saying via its news outlet Amaq that gatherings of al-Wadis and Tardis and Jabalah had been targeted. The al-Wadis is minority sect to which President Bashar al-Assad belongs. So the question is who really did do the attacks? No doubt ISIS is certainly responsible, as you can see in the photographs here on your screen. Very much devastation has happened. One at a hospital as well. Blood everywhere, all over the ground. It's a very, very serious situation. In one particular blast, 45 people dead, police sources initially told RIA. Then the joint death toll was raised to over 100. That's just in one blast alone. Supposedly there's been about four different blasts. Ahmed Nasser al-Din, journalist as well, has been sharing photos. He shared these here along with these photos as well in the area. What is going on there? Very, very much devastation that is taking place here. This here, one particular footage here from Syrian television showing in one particular location here the aftermath of the blast. It is no doubt what I am really concerned about myself is that with this particular type of blast here and the number of the dead and it being as close as it is to Russian airbase, there's not going to be a ceasefire whatsoever. The Geneva talks that they have been working on all this time to bring about a ceasefire is about to become null and void. Now, is that going to raise the stakes? Is that going to cause a conflict eventually that's going to break out between the United States and Russia if there is not a truce brought about? They've been working on this for quite some time in Geneva. We were in Geneva back when the talks began at the very hotel where opposition to the Syrian government was staying at. We were there with even U.S. experts there speaking with them there. But this is clearly a situation that could easily spiral out of control. No doubt Bashar al-Assad will have to respond to these type terrorist attacks. Russia will have to engage in that. And it's not going to bring about a true lasting ceasefire. So very concerning to us what's going on here. We will be on the border in Syria very soon trying to cover the types of events that are going on that you're seeing, not in Syria, but at the border where we can see the action from a distance to see what is going on, especially around Damascus area and also north of Damascus to see exactly what's going on. Keep us in your prayers as we near that time for that departure there to Israel. Also, those of you that want to help support this particular endeavor, this prophetic news broadcast that we'll be bringing to you live from Israel, we certainly need your help in the trip. You can go to israelinewslive.org. You'll see that at the end of the broadcast there, along with israelreturns.com, both websites. Either one you can donate on via the internet there. Occasionally we get some people saying they're having trouble logging into the website, some servers. But thanks to some of the inside Vatican insiders, they're trying to block access to our website. Try to use a different server, and also we'll post in the comment section on YouTube a direct link to where you can donate if you'd like to be a part of that. We thank you for your help. God bless you. and we will be keeping you up. Be sure, sign up with Livestream, Israeli News Live on Livestream. A link will be in the YouTube section of the broadcast for you there so that you can keep up with the latest things that are going on. We are stepping up our reporting efforts to bring to you things that are breaking and going on around the world. Also, later this evening, I'll be looking into the new novel by the British general about the war with Russia in 2017. Is it just fiction, or is there some truth to the matter of this? Be a very interesting broadcast, no doubt. I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. Shalom.